There are three functions in DAX to compute period-to-date calculations. They are DATESYTD, DATESQTD, DATESQTD, and DATESMTD. DATESYTD returns the year-to-date. So you see in this example that if the filter context contains one date only, the 12th of May 2020, DATESYTD returns all the dates from the 1st of January up to the 12th of May. Dates quarter to date goes returns the quarter to date, so from the 1st of April up to the 12th of May, and dates month to date returns all the dates in the current month, starting from the 1st of May and reaching the end of the current period. So if you have only one day in the selection, the result is just simple. If the selection contains multiple dates, like in this case where we have dates starting from the 10th of March up to the 12th of May, then the period to date calculations, they always use the last date as the reference. So regardless of when your period starts, all these functions use the 12th of May and returns the YTD, the QTD, or the MTD start using the 12th of May. The three functions always also have a counterpart, a syntax sugar version of the same calculation. You can use TOTALYTD, TOTALQTD, and TOTALMTD that do not require the usage of calculate. So when you write TOTALYTD of sales amount and you use date as an argument, it is translated into calculate sales amount DATESYTD. We prefer not to use these syntax sugar functions because they are hiding the context transition that might be happening because of calculate. And this is why in the description we only use the DATESYTD, DATESQTD, and DATEMTD functions. The counterpart, the syntax sugar counterpart, works the same without the need for calculate. Let's now see some examples of usage. In this first example, I set in the filter context the 12th of May 2007 and I compute the DATESYTD. The result contains all the dates starting from the 1st of January 2007 up to the 12th of May 2007. So all the dates between the 1st of January of the current year and the last visible date are included in the result set, which of course is a table because we will need to use it as a filter argument of calculate. If you use DATESMTD, the result does not contain data starting from the 1st of January, but instead starts from the 1st of May. You see that we have data starting from the 1st of May and going to the 12th of May 2007. If the selection contains a range, like in this case, I compute the DATESYTD starting from the 5th of February up to the 12th of May, the 5th of February is basically ignored. DATESYTD returns dates starting from the 1st of January up to the 12th of May. You see that we have the 1st of January and it goes up to the 12th of May. It's important to remember that all these functions are table functions. The result of nearly all time intelligence functions is a table because they are designed to be used as filter argument in calculate. You typically use DATESYTD to do calculate whatever measure and then DATESYTD in order to change the filter context. DATESYTD needs to return a table so that it is used as a filter argument in calculate to change the filter context and force the calculation in the YTD. This calculator is executed inside an outer calculate that filters only one date. But because DATESYTD is present, the sales amount is computing for all the dates from the 1st of January 2007 up to the 12th of May 2007. In your code, you typically do not have the outer calculate because that is coming from the Power BI report or whatever client tool is running the query and it is evaluating your measure. And another important detail about all these functions, all the time intelligence function, including DATESYTD and the period to date functions, is that even though you specify just a column reference in most of the scenarios, these functions actually require a table as their first argument. And if you just use date, the engine rewrites your code using calculate table distinct date. This is important because the presence of calculate table means that context transition might be happening. If you are running these calculations inside a row context, there might be context transition and you need to pay attention to that. Let's now take a look at a practical example of the usage of this function. I create a measure that computes the quarter to date and another measure that computes the year to date, which I then produce in a report that shows the year month, the sales amount, the QTD and the YTD. You see that sales amount shows the sales in the current month. Quarter to date shows values for the current month, the sum of the first and the second, the sum first, second and third together. And when the quarter starts again, the function resets and starts counting again. Year to date, on the other hand, starts like quarter to date, but when the quarter changes, it does not change its value and it goes on growing. It will reset its value on January 2008 when the new year starts.